Hello again, brothers and sisters in Christ. Now it is Monday the 17th, and it's 9:08 p.m., and I was about to close down when I saw a comment. I believe that's where I got it, in my comments. Well, anyway, this is Paul Begley, and this is titled, Prophecy, Thousands of Jews Pray to Stop the Coronavirus. Now listen to this just a few minutes, and then I will link it so you can go watch it yourself. He's very excited, and this is very, very exciting. Gosh, I wish we could all get together and do that. This is called Prophecy, Thousands of Jews Pray to Stop Coronavirus Plague. All right, and the channel is Paul Begley. Okay, for those of you who can't see the description box, you just type it out in the search bar at the top and you'll get it. All right, listen to this.
Event. It's unbelievable what's happened, and I feel so good. And so in a few moments, I'm going to show you something that's 2,000 years old that we have, and it goes along with this story. I'm so excited. Heidi handed it to me. I said, oh my, this is unbelievable. Guys, thousands and thousands of Jews gathered and praying to stop the coronavirus plague, just like Moses and Aaron did back in the book of Numbers, in chapter 16, so many years ago. Matter of fact, thousands of Jews, praise God, hallelujah.
Amen. Praise God.
Thousands of
praise
Jews are praying and went to the Western Wall and were praying last night to stop the plague, to stop the plague of the coronavirus epidemic. And this was all, and Rabbi Eliyahu said, we are committed to every person. We're committed to every person, he said. Everybody put a thumbs up right now in agreement. Put a thumbs up right now in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Are you serious? Now, on Sunday, this mass prayer session was held at the Western Wall, facing the Holy Mountain of God, where the temple once was. And thousands of Jews begin to pray to stop the plague of the coronavirus that began in Wuhan, China, in December of last year. The virus has already affected, and let me give you the numbers up to date, 73,304 people have been affected, 1,872 have died. This is unbelievable. 73,304 have been affected, 1,872 have died. Those are the numbers that's been released from the world governments, but we know the number is 10 times, maybe 20 times, maybe 50 times higher. Nobody knows, as there's been incredible information coming out now. But boy.
Okay, I'm going to stop it there. I just wanted to give you a little preview of what he's talking about here. And I think that this is fantastic. Now, of course, he doesn't say, are they Jews, regular Orthodox Jews, or Messianic Jews? Does it matter? I don't think so. We both believe in the same God. They just don't believe in the Savior. And he is the one, of course, that shed his blood to save us. But, of course, the ones who are Orthodox and following all of their Old Testament laws, I'm sure God the Father must be paying attention to them. But I say, why don't we do the same thing? Of course, I know all of you are praying against it. Oh, my goodness, how I want to have how I would love to get a big old group together like that somewhere and just be praying, everybody praying against this coronavirus. Let's do it right now, everybody. If I pray in tongues, which I know I will, you just pray in English. You just keep on praying. Everybody just pray your own words. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this group of Jews that you have brought together to pray against the coronavirus. And we ask you, please, Lord, listen to them. Listen to us. Listen to our pleas. O sandala miki sono kashana masiti. Kandala maki soto shandala katai. Gasita kotora mono masani mono katere shisa kata. Kati sandala pati katori mala shika to soto katasi. Andala mana katasi. I ask you, Lord, to heal every single person that has it right now. I don't care if they're on death's door. I ask you to put your hand of healing upon them and heal what they're calling what looks like ground glass in their chest x-ray report. I ask you, Lord, to dissipate that and pull it out and heal their lungs and let them live. And let not one more die from this, O Lord. I am begging you to stop this plague unless it is your will to allow it to bring others to you. If that is happening and that is how you want it to happen, then of course we pray, let your will be done. But we know it is your will that none should perish. And how many of these people are ready to meet you, Lord? So we don't want you or Jesus to be saddened by all the numbers dying and going to hell. We want to see them healed so that they can say, I survived that and I was at death's door. And someone can come through and say, that was God that healed you. There are some in that country and the other countries where people are affected that can tell them that. Lord, we pray for boldness. We pray that we all have more boldness to open our mouths and be able to say that to somebody who would say to us, I almost died of that. And they said, I just made a miraculous recovery. Isn't that something? I think that's wonderful. And they don't even mention God. That's where you step in. And Lord, we pray that every single one of us will have more boldness to speak it out and tell other people that. Do you know how many people were at death's door and then all of a sudden got recovered? Do you know why that happened? Because thousands of us were praying. Even the Jews in Jerusalem were praying against the coronavirus. And look at it now. It's nearly gone. Oh, Lord, how wonderful and awesome that would be. Only to give you the credit and the glory and to get other people to realize that you still do miracles. Lord, we pray for every single sick person right now. In Jesus' name, I ask you, Lord Jesus, let them be healed by your blood. Father, we know it is your will that none should perish. So I'm asking you, and I pray all my subscribers are in agreement with me, that you would heal each and every one so that they could be told by someone, God healed you. God did that. That's what God did. Do you see now? And how many would be saved because of that? Lord, I pray that would happen in Jesus' precious and holy name. Amen, amen, and amen. I will end this here and link this video in the description box for anybody who would like to hear the rest of it. It is altogether 20 minutes and 3 seconds. Okay, I find this exciting and I will finish listening to it later. I just had to stop and report on it to give you all a chance to watch it. Okay, bye for now. Oh, I'm going to plead the blood of Jesus over it. And over myself and my computer, and over each and every one of you, and all of your devices, and over all of your internet connections. And with that, I'll say bye for now. I will talk to you later.